Leadoff Man is brought to you by your local Chicago and Northwest Indiana Hyundai dealers. Visit buyhyundai.com today.
Couple of Lynns, the great Lynn Bramer, along with Lin-Manuel Miranda from Hamilton fame. To a Lynn, and I guess a quick plug for Len and Lynn, Mondays at 8:30 on XRT. Now to our best friend in the world.
1984 Cubs baseball was a dream walk in the park. The sky seemed a little bluer. The ivy was a little bit greener. And if you check the upper right center bleachers, the guy in the straw hat was Bill Veeck. Hey, this was 1984. The signs in the windows said no lights in Wrigley Field, and there were none. When the afternoon shadows fell across home plate and Lee Smith was scowling on the mound, well, it was just too bad for the other team. And in the bleachers, the beer vendors could still deliver refreshments, and the guys who had smoked cigars for 20 or 30 years carried on that august tradition. And the Mets were still in our division to be hated. Spring training 84, nobody picked the Cubs. They went 7-20 in the preseason. But Dallas Green, general manager, made some trades. Cubs picked up Dernier and Matthews from the Phillies in March. They got Eckersley for Buckner in May, and then the big one, June 14th. The Cubs acquired Rick Sutcliffe from the Cleveland Indians. And as any Cub fan can tell you, the Red Baron won the Cy Young Award after going 16-1 for the Cubs in 84. June 23rd, Cubs Cards Wrigley Field. The game on national TV. Ryan Sandberg went 5-for-6 with 7 RBIs. He tied up the game with a home run in the bottom of the ninth. He tied the game again in the 10th with another home run.
Way back! Might be out of here!
Cubs went on to win, and Cards manager Whitey Herzog called Sandberg, quote, the greatest baseball player I have ever seen.
Mr. Sandberg, lend us your ear. Our hearts are thumping whenever you're near.
The key series, end of July. Cubs-Mets. The Cubs devastated the Mets, winning 7 out of 8, and found themselves 4.5 games in first place. August 5th, the Sun-Times headline reads, it's Cubs fever. September 24th, I found myself in a tavern on Rush Street. I'm watching Sutcliffe toss a two-hitter against the Pirates. He strikes out Joe Orsulak in the bottom of the ninth. Cubs win 4-1, and the city of Chicago is up for grabs. Wrigley Field is engulfed. Cubs clinch the East. The Chicago National League Ball Club is facing postseason baseball for the first time since 1945. Remember the beginning of the playoffs at Wrigley Field? Cubs 13, San Diego Padres nothing. Sarge hit 2 homers. And Rick Sutcliffe?
High to right, way back, this ball is gone.
Second game, a beauty. A 4-2 victory, 5-hitter for Trout. You really thought this was it. No team in history had ever blown a National League Championship Series after being up 2-0. You were actually talking about your buddy who had World Series tickets. There are forces at work in the universe that we will never understand. So much unexplained, so much that fills us with wonder. Your personal nightmare swirls with a routine ground ball to a Cubs first baseman. The satanic grin of a San Diegan named Garvey. You have to let go. Let the images recede and the pain will fade. It's not Durham. It's not the goat. It's destiny. And it's bigger than all of us.
Hard to believe, 35 years ago, the East Division champions. First time in the postseason since 1945. One note on the Rhino game. Bob Costas had the play-by-play call on NBC TV. He was reading the credits when Rhino tied that game with his second home run in extra innings.